Why does an apple thrown up in the air come to a stop? Well, we know that it is a force of gravity acting in the downward direction that slows it down. Interestingly, the same idea can be explained in terms of loss of kinetic energy of the apple as it rises up and the work that the force of gravity does on it. So, let's once again throw the apple up in the air and see what exactly is happening at every stage of the flight. Let us assume that the initial velocity is V0, which therefore means that you have imparted a certain initial kinetic energy to it. Now, as the apple moves up, you see its velocity is reducing since the force of gravity is acting against it. And in physics, we say that this force of gravity is doing negative work on the apple. So, the apple has now reached the top and the velocity has become zero. Also, let us say the displacement is D. Basically, the force of gravity has done enough negative work on the apple to reduce the velocity to zero, and therefore its kinetic energy has also become zero. So, how do we find the magnitude of work done on the apple and also conclude that it is negative? Well, it is quite simple. All you need to do is use the formula work done is equal to the dot product of force of gravity and the displacement D, where we know that theta is the angle between the force of gravity and displacement. And here we can see that the force vector is acting in the downward direction while the displacement is in the opposite direction and 180 degrees apart. So, when you put theta as 180 degrees here, what you get is work done is equal to force of gravity into displacement D into minus 1, because cos of 180 is minus 1, or work done is equal to minus force of gravity times displacement D. Or we could expand this further to say that work done by gravity is equal to minus mg into d, because the force of gravity is nothing but the product of mass and gravity. So, if the apple has a mass of 1 kilogram, displacement is 10 meters, and the value of g is, let us say, 10 meters per second square, we can say that the work done by the force of gravity is w is equal to minus 1 into 10 into 10, which equals minus 100 joules. And the minus sign here tells us that during the apple's rise, the gravitational force acting on it transfers a kinetic energy of 100 joules from the apple, which also seems consistent with the slowing down of the apple as it rises. Now, the apple starts its downward journey and undergoes the same magnitude of displacement D. Then, the work done by the force of gravity can again be given as W is equal to force of gravity into D into cos 0, which equals force of gravity into D into plus 1. And why have we taken 0 here? Because this time we can see that the force of gravity and displacement D are parallel and in the same direction. So we can expand this to write the work done by the force of gravity as W is equal to mgd. And we can see that the force of gravity has done positive work on the apple this time, which again makes sense because this force has enabled increase in the kinetic energy of the apple. Okay, now let us take a variation of what we did. That is, instead of throwing the apple up, we lift the apple up by applying a vertical force in the upward direction to it. Now, since the force applied is in the upward direction and the displacement is also in the upward direction, the work done is positive. And let us call it WA, that is the work done by the applied force. But then you should not forget that the force of gravity is also acting on the apple. And since it is acting in the downward direction, while the displacement is happening in the upward direction, we can say that the force of gravity is doing negative work. So, we can conclude here that the applied force tends to transfer energy to the apple, while the gravitational force tends to transfer energy out of the apple. Now, we know that the change in kinetic energy is equal to the total work done. Or in this case, we can say that the change in kinetic energy of the apple is equal to the work done by the applied force plus the work done by the gravitational force. Now, you should understand and remember that this equation will apply even when you are bringing down the object. The only difference is when you're bringing it down, the applied force is doing negative work simply because the displacement is happening in the downward direction while the applied force is acting in the upward direction. And the force of gravity does positive work because the force is acting in the downward direction and the displacement is also happening in the downward direction. So in this situation, we see that the object or the apple is stationary before and after the lift, quite like you lifting a book from the floor to the shelf. We can therefore say that kinetic energy final and kinetic energy initial both are zero. Therefore, WA or the work done by the applied force plus WG or the work done by the force of gravity equals zero, or WA is equal to minus WG. So we see that the magnitude of work done by the applied force and the force of gravity is the same. However, the applied force here is transferring energy into the object while the force of gravity is taking the energy out of the object. And since the magnitudes are the same, the sign is opposite, total work done becomes zero, and therefore the change in kinetic energy also becomes zero. So we can further write this as the work done by gravity or the force of gravity is equal to minus mgd, and therefore this equals m into g into d. So you could do the same derivation when the apple is brought down. So the equation delta k is equal to kf dash minus ki dash would equal WA plus WG does not change, and again these two quantities are zero, and what we get is WA is equal to minus WG. That is, still the work done by the applied force is negative of the work done by the force of gravity. The only difference here is that we take the angle as zero because the force of gravity and the displacement both are in the same direction. So the work done by the applied force equals minus mgd. Now, one important thing to remember is that this equation is true only when the initial and the final kinetic energy is zero or of the same magnitude. That is, the kinetic energy could be, let us say, 10 joules in the beginning and 10 joules in the end. However, if the initial and final kinetic energy is not the same, this equation will not be true because this would be a non-zero value, or WA plus WG would equal to K, where K will be a non-zero value. Another very interesting observation you can make is that in both the situations, the work done by the applied force is independent of the magnitude of the force. It only depends on the mass M of the object and the displacement D. So even if you had changed the magnitude of force while lifting the apple from this point to this point, the magnitude of work done would still have been mgd. Well, this lesson is not an easy one. So what I would suggest is that if you go through this playlist, your comprehension would increase manifold. And like always, please leave a comment if you like the lesson. That will be helpful. And see you in the next lesson.